Japan's most famous comic hero was created by a doctor, Osamu Tezuka.
これはですね、人間型のロボットで、2003年に日本で発明されたロボットということになっています。で、アストロボイって言うんですかね。これは当時はスーパーヒーローですよ。で、そのスーパーヒーローでもですね、これはロボットですから、人間にできないことがいろいろあります。例えばその宇宙空間に行っても、このロボットはその呼吸をしませんからね。 ロケットの力でどこへでも飛んでいきます。それから100カ国語が喋れるとか、それから人の心の善悪を見分ける力があるとかね、いろんな超能力があるわけです。それで科学者とそれから子供たちの味方になって平和のために戦うという物語ですね。 僕は一番恐ろしいのは、特に日本人の場合ですね、よく言われてることは、つまり日本人は管理社会が非常に徹底していて、すべてこの団体でこの行動する、あるいはその一つのその方向にですね、全部そちらへ向いてしまうという性格がどうもあるようなんで、これがそのロボットに非常に似てるんじゃないかということなんですけどね。一番大きな非難は、その日本人はクリエイティビティがない、 つまり全て イミテーションであるということですね。で、僕は今までは分かりません。つまりいろいろ海外の文明を日本に持ってくるにはですね、日本の方はそれを鵜呑みにして真似するということが一番簡単なことだということが、もう常識みたいになってたわけですけど、これからは日本人のクリエイティビティというものが すごく尊重されるというよりも、それが発揮できるんじゃないかと思います。それの一番が僕は知能ロボットだと思うんですよ。知能ロボットの発展のためにですね、日本人が新たに何か一つのものを作り上げるという、そういう時代が来るような気がします。 21世紀には。
Tezuka began drawing comic strips in the immediate post-war years when Japan needed entertainment which was cheap and escapist and encouraging to the national morale. Today he's regarded as the father of the comic book movement, which has grown into a multi-billion yen industry. Comics and picture books are read by virtually everyone in Japan, but they don't all have the high moral tone of Tezuka's work. Often they're explicitly erotic. The popularity of the comics is astonishing. More than 1,000 million copies are sold every year. Perhaps this escape into fantasy may be seen as a safety valve in a society where pressures to conform can become intolerable. Some people see comics as the paperback equivalent of TV, instant information conveniently packaged for rapid consumption in a land obsessed with time and efficiency. Others find in the comic books the symptoms of a decline in spiritual values, but a visit to Tokyo's Kanda area should reassure them. Kanda is the bibliophile's paradise, a district crammed with bookshops. The history of the novel in Japan goes back to the 11th century tale of Genji, but here the majority of titles are from overseas, foreign books in Japanese translation. For all their addiction to television, the Japanese are voracious readers. They claim to be the biggest importers of books in the world, and as a result, to be the world's most literate people. This, they say, is the true secret to their economic success, because a workforce that reads is flexible and able to make the best use of new ideas. A foreign book which became an instant bestseller bore the title Japan as Number One. By the year 2000, it predicted Japan's per capita income will have comfortably overtaken that of the United States. But today, there's a mood of caution among the country's leaders, a worry that social change will deny Japan the realization of her great ambition. Young people are not as committed as their parents were, and many of them now choose to enjoy the fruits of prosperity in bars and nightclubs rather than spend their evenings entertaining business clients. We've worked hard, they say. We've earned the time to enjoy ourselves.
You know,
now on a hit at Circuit City.
Those who predict a general decline in the future are probably worrying without cause. The Japanese are taking more time off, but they're spending their money on Japanese products. So it's Japanese industry which stands to benefit.
But there certainly have been a lot of funny incidents in connection with looking like the president. One occasion, we were down in Daytona Beach. I was with my old buddy, Dick Tracy, a retired insurance man. And we're walking on the beach, and this young lady in a yellow string bikini spots me and comes running up and jumping up and down. She says, "I voted for you." I was afraid she was going to break her string.
That's funny. Well, listen, we have one more, not a celebrity lookalike, but I mean the real thing. He heard that Gene Kasem was here. He came storming up here in a cab. And here's Dan Hedaya from the Tortellis. Right here. Yeah. Hi, Dan. How you doing?
It's good to be on
It's nice to have you.
That's great. Why don't you lower the deficit or something? How are you doing, Bert?
Listen, thank you all very, very much for being with us. Of course, Fred Travellino. We'll be back again, everybody. Thank you for joining us, and bye-bye for now.
The piano used on the... We'll be right back.